All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to yet another episode of the Ashish David Show. And, you know, I'm so grateful and so glad that, so many people are getting in touch with me. People from our country, people from abroad. And the best part is that, I'm getting to have these great conversations, which is basically what the show is about. And that is how we have today's guest. And today's guest is not just going to give you food for thought. She might actually give you some great food if you happen to order from, one of her outlets or, however she's sort of distributing her food. Yes, she's a food expert. Like, I don't even know what to call her because I think she's going to be the one who's going to tell us. And one thing I can, reconfirm that after talking to her, you're going to realize that the best relationship in the world is the one that you have with food. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Shabana Sheikh. Shabana, how are you doing?
I am doing awesome.
Shabana, yes. Welcome to the Ashish David Show.
Thank you so much, Ashish, for calling me, and I'm really honored. Thank you so much for calling me.
Are, we are very happy to have you because we both share a passion and love for food. मेरा देख के पता लग रहा है, आपका देख के नहीं पता लग रहा.
नहीं, ये थोड़ा कंट्रोल में
है. So Shabana, we've had a little bit of a phone conversation, we've had messenger talks, and finally you're here on the show. How are you feeling?
Cloud nine. Nice. I'm really feeling very nice, and I'm so excited. मैं actually I was writing that, अच्छा मैं ये बोलूं, then I was like, नहीं ये थोड़ा ज़्यादा हो जाएगा, ये थोड़ा कम हो जाएगा, मुझे ये भी बोलना है, so there were like too many things. Then I said finally,
super.
Close books.
But like the good part is that I'm gonna make sure that you cover everything that you want to talk, okay? Because I think ye mera usually hota hai, mere sare jitne best friends hai na, they're all foodies, okay?
Awesome.
So all our conversations are going to be out. Everything that you want to tell people is going to come out. But let's start from the beginning, Shabana. Firstly, yes. Welcome again to the Ashish David Show.
Thank you.
Shabana, how would you describe yourself to someone who knows absolutely nothing about you?
Okay. So Shabana was born in Bombay,
okay,
and brought up in Mumbai. I come from a foodie family. So right from my grandparents to my parents to us to my next generation of nephew, nieces, everybody is a foodie. I worked for close to 2 decades in finance and insurance. So good 18, 19 years has been in corporate. And then finally I said, thank you very much, keeping awake late nights and too much of traveling, you know how Mumbai is. Finally, I said that, okay, thank you very much. I need to be my own boss. That's when at the peak of my career, I said, okay, and I left. I had no clue what I'm going to do. I really had no clue. And then one fine day, basis, a small discussion with my ammi. Finally, ammi's kitchen bloomed. And
wow.
That's how we are today after 3.5 years.
When you were leaving your job, your corporate, what was on your mind? Because, it could have worked out, it could have not worked out, it could have been a difficult time. What was going on in your mind at that time?
It's a very good question that you have asked me. Unfortunately, this is what I've realized, that we Indians, hamara aisa hardwiring kiya gaya hai, it's been drilled in us that job hi karna hai. Second is job lag gayi, jaise jaise aap you move up the ladder, your needs become luxuries, and then so on so forth, and then you look at others ki aapko kya chahiye wagera. So then you get tied up. Jaise aapki job lagi, the first thing what will you do? You'll buy a home loan. Why? Because you want to save your tax, and that's a vicious cycle. Then, abhi ghar ho gaya. Now, what will you do? You'll buy a car. Again, a loan. And then you get tied up. What happens is then you get into that EMI cycle. Obviously, you do not have the courage then to leave a job. How are you going to pay all that? Plus right. Your parents, your, you get married, etc., etc., etc. This has to be broken. the previous decade and the decade to come, they have to realize this and, you know, train their kids and train themselves that, you know, be your own boss. There are so many creative things. Google is like a bhandar of, you know, giving you so much of knowledge. You know, come out with something which, you know, people do not have. Serve them. Give them something which they need. When I was in that crisis, because I also was, you know, having a home loan. But fortunately, you know, over a period of time, I had made a couple of properties and, you know, invested some money and all that thing that I had done. What I did was I settled everything and I said, okay, now at least I don't have all that. That gut feeling that I had that whatever I do, I can do it. And I will do the best. Being in a corporate life, if I can, you know, spend about 16, 17 hours for somebody else and then do jiujuri and say, okay, yes, boss, you know, get bashed for something you have not done, or probably, you know, that office politics and all that stuff. So I said, you know, rather than doing all that, I might as well spend so many hours in doing something which I love. Yes, for me, it wasn't too difficult to take that jump. But the only thing I can say, Ashish, is I took that leap of faith.
There are a lot of people, Shabana, who are watching us right now, who are in this rut. You know what I mean? You got out of it. You know, maybe I got out of it. But a lot of people are still there. So, unko kya lagta hai na ki yaar, main jump loon, jump na loon, kya karu? So, what I want to tell by this question to people is that, yes, there is never like a 100% guarantee that that jump will work for you. You know, it might not work for you. You might have to come back to a job and then maybe take a later jump again.
Yes.
But
yes,
at some point of time or the other, you have to take a risk.
Yes.
And have faith and hope that everything works out.
In a corporate life, when you switch from one job to the other, usme bhi to risk hai.
Usme bhi risk hai.
You don't know what you're going to expect there, right? The only thing when you move from corporate to being an entrepreneur is that just one thing, that, you know, just be sure of yourself. Every human is born with some skill. You just need to identify what your skill is.
Absolutely. And I think that is a journey which is a lifelong one. Matlab aapke paas kitne skills hain aur aap kya kya kar sakte ho. और आपका किस किस चीज में इंटरेस्ट है. दिस इज समथिंग दैट यू नो एवरी अदर फेज ऑफ योर लाइफ विल टीच यू एंड एवरी अदर हार्डशिप एंड काइंड ऑफ यू नो फेज दैट यू गो थ्रू. सो शबाना, व्हेन यू रियलाइज दैट दिस इज यू नो हो गया, बहुत हो गया, मुझे कुछ और करना है, आफ्टर दैट व्हाट हैपेंड?
सो वन फाइन डे आई जस्ट वेंट टू माय बॉस एंड सेड दिस इज माय पेपर, थैंक यू वेरी मच. एंड दे वर लाइक व्हाट? एंड इट वाज मार्च ईयर एंड. And they just said, just get out. We don't want to talk to you right now. And we will talk to you later. Okay, March, your end, all that happened. And then, everything settled. And then I came back home. It was my last day in office. I was carrying all bouquets, this, that. And I told my mom, I said, okay. So she said, what happened? Why all these flowers and gifts and all that? I said,
oh,
I have
you
resigned.
Didn't tell your mom. You didn't tell your mom.
No, I didn't. So I said, okay, today was my last day. So she was like, so she didn't know what actually to say that, because she knows that I am not a person who will sit idle even for a day. So she's like, so dusra job mil gaya tumko? So I said, no. So she was like, okay. And it was quite late in the night. So she said, okay, kal baat karenge. And then a day, 2 days. And then finally we were just sitting, having lunch. And then casual discussion that, you know, okay, so what are you going to do now? Have you thought about anything? I said, no. And she's like, okay. So what next? So days, just you know, few days passed, and then again, you know, one day we were sitting for lunch, and then she said, "Have you thought about something?" So it just struck me that, you know, so I was telling her, so the conversation started that, oh, you've made such good lunch today, you know, it's so delicious as usual, and, you know, this is my favorite, and thank you very much, and all that. And then that conversation led to an area which I think which neither she or I had thought about. I said that, you know, isn't it surprising that, you know, the cuisine that we have, a Kokni Muslim cuisine, is something that which is so delicious. It is so balanced, but still nobody is aware about this. Unless, you know, you belong to a Kokni Muslim family, or you have, you know, friends or, you know, neighbors or somebody who belongs to that family. So I said that, you know, why don't we explore this? So she was like, what are you talking? I said, yeah, because, so she said, who is going to eat our food? I mean, this is just a simple ghar ka khana. I said, exactly. I said, ghar ka khana hi chahiye. This is what is missing. So one is the cuisine is unique, and Mumbai is a city where people explore food. Anything which is new, not just food, but anything new, and people want, you know, they, you can easily tell them that this is what it is. And if once they like it, you're done. So she said, okay, where should we start off? I mean, have you thought about anything? So I said, see, you know, because, you know, I've been in corporate for like 2 decades. Let's start with the inner circle.
Correct.
So I will tell my friends, you know, my corporate group, my bosses, neighbors, and let's do something. We will just start with a biryani and a pulao, because at least people know that, okay, biryani, pulao, and then eventually we can see how it goes. And then that journey from balance sheet to biryani started. Then the inner circle started spreading, you know, people started talking about us, that, okay, you know, this is the food. And then slowly and steadily we started adding on to the menu. One of the biggest difficulty that I had in the entire year, the first year. So what kind of food do you serve? We serve Kokni Muslim food. Ah, te Malwani. Sorry, not Malwani. But te Goan. No. Then I had to, so, you know, for one full year, I really had to explain that what is the difference between a Kokani food, a Malwani food, a Goan food, and then, you know, the tradition, who we are, and where do we start from, who are our ancestors, blah, 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 everything. So that's how the first year went, in just explaining to people who we are. Our ancestors were Arabs.
Okay.
So Arabs and Persians, they used to come to India for whatever, you know, for business purposes and whatever. So when they came here, eventually there were some people who chose Maharashtra coast. There were some who chose to go to, you know, the Karnataka side. And some, they chose to go to Kerala side. So that is the food that you were having in Muscat, what is the Mapla food or the Mopla food? The people who settled in, or the Arabs or the Persians who settled in you know, towards Karnataka, their cuisine is different. And the ones who settled around the coast of Maharashtra were called as Kokanis. Why? Because they got married to the locals, the fisherwomen's,
correct,
the Kolis. So that is one of the reasons why you find similarities between the dialects of the fisherwoman, if you've heard, you know, in Maharashtra, and the language that Kokani Muslims use. The only difference is that we use more of Urdu. You know, along with the Marathi, you will find Urdu. You will also find similarity between Kokani Muslim food, some of the Hyderabadi food, and some of the Kerala food. There is Kepsa. Now, Kepsa is not an Indian food. You obviously must be knowing, you know, what is kepsa. It's rice and then you have this meat covered on top.
So what they used to call it in Oman is they used to call it mandi. And they used to call it another word they had. Mujhe yaad nahi aa raha abhi, but there was another word for it. So okay. Mandi is like the thing there. So I guess it's the same family of food. Like.
So actually, if you see the Konkani food per se, you know, it will have a combination of Arabian food. It'll have a hint of Persian food. And obviously, you know, because the Arabs and the Persians settled around the coast. So whatever was locally available, like, you know, coconut, fish, bananas, cashews, kokum. So all those are a part of the Konkani food in itself. That is what Konkani food is about. Now, the second part of it. So, this is the overall, you know, cuisine. Now, as and when you, Konkanis start from Thane onwards.
All right.
So, Thane and then Mumbai and then, you know, so and so forth. And they end in Chiplun, just before Goa.
All right. And so, that entire belt. These people.
Yes. Okay. Now, as you jump villages, you will find the food changes. So, example, so we are basically from Varkhal Naka, which is Pen Panvel, closer to Alibag.
Okay.
Now, whether you are a Konkani Muslim or whether you are a Konkani Maharashtrian, as in a Konkani Hindu, the food will be the same. So, we will use less of coconut because it is more towards the city side.
Right.
So we will use less of coconut. Our desserts are not very sweet. We will use kokum. So these are the things that we use. Another thing which people do not know about Konkani Muslims is what they know is they think that Konkani Muslims hai, so they will eat fish, they will eat rice. What else will they eat?
Mm.
And obviously coconut. No, that's not just the thing. If anybody comes to a Konkani Muslim family, they will see that, you know, it is not just the fish. We enjoy our meat. We enjoy chicken. And vegetables is a must in every meal. Trust me, you know, for us, non-vegetarian goes 364 and a half days. 364 and a half days, we have non-veg. Now, why that half day? Half day, we do not eat meat, which is on the day of Muharram, which is Ashura, the 10th day.
Correct.
So, afternoon is something which we do not have non-veg. So, it's basically khichdi and dahi and all that stuff. And then evening, again, we eat a lot of khichda, which is loaded with meat. So, we balance the day. If whenever you have time and when you come over to Mumbai,
yes,
you will actually find in a Konkani Muslim on a Konkani Muslim dastarkhan, you will find a lot of times that the ciders, which we call as tondi lavaila, which is like for the tongue, exceeds the main menu. So it'll be a papad, it'll be achar, it'll be nimbu, it'll be chutney, it'll be kachumbar. So, you know, it's so much those. So you start eating the ciders and you're half full.
That's, I think, that's a great thing, man. I think that's like, you know, it's good for health, I think.
Yes. So you eat less.
Haan, wahi. Matlab, and pata hai, mera shabana kya rehta hai ki whenever I go to like a nice, you know, buffet, मेरा लाइक आई एम सो एक्साइटेड मैं ये भी खाऊंगा वो भी खाऊंगा एंड होता क्या है आई एंड अप हैविंग सो मच सैलड्स एंड लाइक यू नो दोस चीज एंड ब्रेड एंड दिस एंड दैट एंड जब असली खाने की बात बारी आती है ना तो बिल्कुल जी और मन और पेट सब कुछ ही भर जाता है
सो यू अंडरस्टूड दिस इज द ट्रिक दैट Konkani Muslims have
यस सो माय कनेक्शन विद महाराष्ट्र इज दैट ओके सो most of my listeners don't know this, but I'm actually a Marathi. So my dad is, he's ex-army. Okay. So he's Captain David John Mishramkar.
Okay.
Technically, I should have been Ashish Mishramkar, but my father in his intelligence, matlab mujhe lagta hai, I have a sense of humor, but my dad is like next level. Wo mera baap hai, sense of humor. When he settled in Delhi with my mother, my mother's from the Delhi region. So when they got married and settled here, my father, in his ultimate, intelligence, he thought to himself that, you know, bacche Delhi mein agar inka naam maine Vishram kar rakh diya na, to unko sab bolenge Vishram kar. Like, so for some reason, all the three kids, our surnames are registered as Ashish David, Reena David, Leena David. So his first name is our surname. And baki maine uska baad mein aur kachumbar bana diya by adding numerology to my surname, and now it's a lot of D's there.
Yes.
By everything, I am a Marathi only. But born and brought up in Delhi, of course. So mujhe Marathi bolni nahi aati. पर मुझे मराठी खाना बहुत अच्छा लगता है. जब मैं बॉम्बे जाता हूँ, मेरे बहुत अच्छे अच्छे दोस्त हैं वहाँ पे. सो
आई एम वन मोर.
यस, एब्सोल्युटली मैन. एंड जैसे बोलते हैं ना, लाइक सी, वी ऑलरेडी मेड इट वेरी क्लियर इन द वेरी बिगिनिंग ऑफ द शो, द रिलेशनशिप यू हैव विद फूड इज द बेस्ट वन.
यस, एब्सोल्युटली.
सी, पीपल कैन लेट यू डाउन, बट फूड कांट. इवन इफ इट्स बैड फूड, यू स्टिल हैव इट, राइट? लाइक यू कुड नॉट हैव इट. So, Shivana, tell us then, what was the next thing that happened in your life? So, you did all your research, you thought ki chalo acha isse start karte hain, pulao and biryani. Then, that inner circle started to grow.
Okay, so after for about a year or so, we were only sticking to biryani, pulao, and it was obviously, at least in my corporate circle, everybody knew, my friend circle knew, what kind of food that we have. And they had been to our place, for Eid, even uninvited. So Eid was never an invitation. Okay, hello, we are coming. Okay. So it was like that. So after that, then we thought that, let's add some gravies and let's add some rotis and, those kind of things, which is very typical to us. And Ashish, we were, then and even now, we are very, very clear that our menu will not have anything other than Kokni Muslim cuisine. Today, Ammi's Kitchen is identified because we are sticking to our roots. We are sticking to our regional cuisine. Anything which is with Kokni Muslims, if it's not there in our menu, you tell us, we will make it for you. But, you don't ask me for a fried rice, please, ever. Or a butter chicken, ever. So, so then we started growing the menu. We started adding gravies, different kind of fish gravies that we have, the bhakris that we have, and the ciders, the tondi lavaila that we have, like the thecha, and the achar and papad that we have. The other thing that we started doing was, so before the adverse, let me tell you the good things, so the listeners will also like. I love to knit everything around a story, which probably comes from my grandfather. So any new thing that I used to add in my menu, so I used to talk about what is it and why this, some story around it. And some background of the tradition or the culture, people started relating. There were some who said that, in our region it's called this, in West Bengal it is called this. So people started connecting with my write-ups and whatever I started writing about food. So a lot of times it used to happen that, when I used to write just one liner, people used to say, "Kya ho gaya? Aaj nahi likha kuch." I've got messages where people have said that, we get up to your message of food or the pictures of food. It's so nice. So that's how, I every day, religiously do my posting and, keep the customers or the guests engaged. So that's how we slowly and steadily grew. One biggest issue that we had was managing the stocks. It's a big challenge because what used to happen is, these are all perishable items like vegetables, meat, and we don't get everything and, just stock it up because we are a home-run kitchen. How much will you stock? the way we eat things or prepare things at for our consumption, that is exactly the way we prepare for our guests. There is no difference. So everything what we prepare is fresh. So at times, you know, guests used to order and then they used to cancel. Waste. People used to, you know, say that, okay, no, we will get back. And, you know, that didn't happen. At times we used to estimate that, you know, okay, abhi weekend hai, you know, probably because last weekend mein bahut achha ho gaya tha business. Maybe this weekend it will happen. Boom. It didn't work. So, you know, we didn't have any option rather than, you know, cook everything and distribute it to the neighbors. You know, it is better that, you know, somebody eats rather than we throwing things away.
यार मैं आपका पड़ोसी होता तो मजे आ जाते बट था नहीं
सीरियसली
आई वुड जस्ट लाइक प्रेफर लिविंग क्लोज टू यू क्या पता खाना मिल जाए
सो दैट वाज यू नो मैनेजिंग स्टॉक्स वाज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज व्हिच यू नो वी हैव मास्टर्ड इट राइट नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ माय मम्मी एंड माय सिस्टर नाउ वी नो हाउ टू मैनेज थिंग्स second is on, you know, where guest is to say that, okay, I will make the payment, you keep the food ready, and then finally say, okay, sorry, I don't want. So that is out. So now we ensure that, you know, the payment has come in.
Yeah.
Especially, you know, if you're a first time client, then, you know, the payment has come in, and only then we say that. And, you know, the our guests appreciate the fact that, you know, we are very transparent. We don't try to talk, you know, in rounded up way and then say no or whatever. So it's very clear. So that's taken care of. The third biggest issue was managing the deliveries. It was a big issue because when we started off, it was just the family members except my ammi. We all used to run around to do the deliveries. You know, bike pe ja rahe hain, auto mein ja rahe hain. We've also done Ola and Uber for bigger orders. So that is something that now, you know, with the help of, you know, one or two other very dear home chefs, you know, who've been in this community for a long time. So they said, Shivana, don't worry, you know, this is how you do it. So then we started using these delivery agencies where you really don't need to tie up with them. So there's just an app, you log in there and that's it. It's taken care of. The other thing that we had an issue was, you know, with the delivery charges. We very clear that, you know, we are charging you a delivery cost, which is standard across the city, flat. Okay. And we also tell you that what are we doing with that money? So there is 50% which goes obviously to the delivery partners who do the deliveries for us. The rest 50% we collect and we keep adding money to that, you know, and then we donate that money. So we donate in terms of food, we donate in terms of clothes, we donate in terms of textbooks, stationery, or whatever you know it requires. We donate in terms of sanitary pads, medicines. So we upfront tell the, you know, when we have new guests, they say, "Arey kya 200 rupees delivery charge kar rahe ho aap aise waise." So we tell them that this is what it is, and they are happy to actually, you know, say that, okay, we are okay with it. So the bonding that we've created with our guests is beautiful. We actually don't call them clients or customers. So whenever we talk to them, or, you know, so they come up with orders and say, okay, you know, we want to order. So we always say that, you know, for how many guests, or, you know, when we put an appreciation post, we say that, you know, our guests said it.
These were all, like, you know, the ups and downs that you faced, and now everything is stable, everything is great. Like, how did the pandemic affect your business, Shivana?
I think last year when suddenly everything happened and, you know, nobody knew what's going to happen, and everything was a chaos. I think just for about 1.5-2 months, intentionally, we actually closed doors. So we are into home dine-in also, Ashish. So we have food being delivered at your doorsteps, and you could also come over to our place and enjoy the food in a very traditional way and all that. So we closed doors. We said that, till the time the pandemics are over, we will not invite guests. Other than that, for about one and a half months, we stopped deliveries. We said that because there is so much of panic, people are in so much of fear. While they trust us, they know that, the food is going to come right from our home kitchen. But we didn't want that, people should have any doubts that, whether it's going to be safe or whatever. So just about for 1.5 months, we had closed doors. But after that, it was fine. And thanks to the state government that, this pandemic, they have allowed home deliveries. Pandemic did not affect us that much, Ashish, is because we are very consistent in, keeping connected with our guests. In any kind of industry that you are, it is very important that, you keep connected, you connect with your customer, you keep in touch with your customer, you keep telling them this is what's happening. So that connection through social media was always there. So we never lost touch. So I think a lot of people miss out on that thing that, you are suddenly one day you say that, okay, hello, I'm a home chef. And then after 1 month, till about 30 days, you've disappeared. And then again, you say, okay, I'm back. So that will not work. So, because of that, consistency, pandemic, touch wood, did not affect us.
People just have a great product or a great business, but they aren't able to like really connect. And I think you've kind of managed to do that with what you're doing.
Don't be mechanical. Leave that for restaurants. If you're a home chef, the art of food, the art of, cooking, comes from here. It doesn't come from here. So let words flow from here. Tell people what you're cooking. And don't try to jump all over. That's one of the mistakes that people do. And like I said earlier, that we have stuck to our niche. So that is one thing. We've been consistent. Every post that we write on social media, if you happen to pick up any food post, we write, people who have started knowing me earlier now and the people who knew me earlier, they actually tell me that, Shabana, it is you. Nobody else can write this. Because we know you so well, we just know that, you are the one who've written. And that makes that connect. So food is one thing. And, obviously the way you describe what you are giving to your guest. You have to take your guest in an imaginary food world. That's what I do. So, and then when we don't have events or, I don't have anything explicitly to tell the guest, then I, sit with my ammi and ask her that, acha, bachpan mein kya hua tha, ye hua tha, phir aap kya karte the? And she's a very shy person. So, we have to actually somewhere in the corner keep the recording on without letting her know. And then that's when, so I am not a blogger, but I write, about food, just about our food, So it could be like I mentioned about the Tondila Vaila. So I write about that. A lot of people didn't know about what is the difference between a khichda and a haleem and a haris. So I've written about that. So, all those things create have created and are creating buzz for us. That, okay, here is a home chef who is not just talking about, she's a home chef. Her mother is preparing food. Her sister is preparing food. Just like another home chef. Here is a home chef who's giving you a very unique cuisine, the cuisine which is not served by anybody else other than their family in Mumbai. She also talks about, the food culture. They also have a home dining facility. There are a lot of things that, she talks about on her page. About her family, about the the difference between, you know, a Muslim community food and a Konkani food. How is it different? So there are a lot of these things keeping the religion separate. So people don't look at us, okay, you know, when I say Konkani Muslim community, matlab, that M is more prominent. No. So for us, you know, that is out. What we are talking about is only food. Yeah. And the food culture around that.
And, you know, Shabana, another thing that I'm pretty sure a lot of people who are watching this will want to know is, say somebody who's great at cooking, who has a certain, you know, like cuisine that is running in the family, just like yours is, and they want to make a business out of that, you know, what are some of, you know, like advice that you would give to people? Because you're someone who's already done it and who's doing it successfully now for 3 years at least. How would you like to guide them as to how to go about it?
Okay, so they can join a women entrepreneurs program. So other than that, one is whatever cuisine you want to stick to, like I said, that don't jump into too many things. So suppose if you're from Delhi, just stick. So Delhi doesn't have their cuisine as such. It's just right. That, you know, they have come up with amazing stuff. So if you're from Delhi, you stick to Delhi food, you know, where people would relate, acha ye agar soya chaap hai to ye to wo Delhi wala hi hona chahiye, ya butter chicken hai to wo Delhi wala hona chahiye. If you're from Hyderabad or Bengal or Mangalorean or wherever you're a Gujarati, stick to the food that you've known. Stick to it. Okay. Yeah, but not necessary. So suppose if you're a Gujarati, but if you know Mexican food very well, and when I say very well, does not mean just cooking. The problem is that, you know, we think that okay, humne acha khana bana liya, char logon ne tarif kar li, so okay, ho gaya. Hum to home chef ho gaye. No, you have to know why a particular ingredient is added or not added in a particular cuisine. That's very important. So stick to the cuisine that you know, you think you know about, knowledge wise and cooking wise. Okay, and you're doing a complete justice. Do not try to create that fusion thing. If you're going to do fusion, then you just stick to fusion. Then you say that boss, I'm the fusion hi karne wale. So that's one. Second is, do not compromise on quality. Maybe, you know, you want to have that, you know, a little high pricing. That's okay. Please. People will, you know, they are more than happy to pay that extra money rather than, you know, getting your, you know, food quality compromised. So never compromise on the quality of food. Three is, be consistent and connected with your guests. Be active on social media. You cannot say that, you know, I will sit in my cocoon and mere building walo ko maine bata diya, haan, and they will go and tell. Today's time, even a five-year-old kid has a phone. Today, even the remotest part of the country is on phone. And that's the most easiest way and the most sasta, sundar and tikau way to get connected. And lastly, when you are on social media, you also have to see what are you communicating. You know, it cannot be that, you know, you're just writing one-liners as if, you know, for the heck of it, you're writing. You really have to connect.
So if you are passionate about it, you know, it'll transcend in your social media.
Yes, and, correct.
Whatever
correct.
Cuisine that you choose to do, kind of like stick to one thing, you know, specialize yes. in that. Try not to be like a jack of all trades and master of none.
Right.
Right, and that correct. Is how people will build their niche in something. And besides right. just the cooking aspect, which is of course a big part, try to get yourself some kind of education regarding what is yes. there in the food, why is it there, you know, if there is any story or something regarding the food, you should be up to date about that as well, right?
Yes, you have to keep you know, your knowledge up. You cannot say that, you know, ha mujhe itna aata hai aur yahi hai. No. Like, so when we started with the kitchen thing, so there are a lot of things that, you know, we've heard from our grandparents and, you know, my dad has said, my mom has said, there are so many things that they keep talking about. Other than that, you know, every time, you know, I call up my cousins, I call up, you know, my relatives, just to know more. So when I go to Uran is one place where you find a hell lot of Kokanis there. When I go there, you know, I actually tell them, you know, I tell my cousins, can you take me to any of your friends' place? And then I sit with their grandmothers and their parents that, okay, you know, you tell me something more. You know, so that's how, you know, it keeps your knowledge up. Use internet in the right form. Use to increase your knowledge about what you are going to do, the business that you are interested in. And you have to be consistent. You need the guests. It's period. Of course, you know, they want to have your food and all that stuff. But you need the guest when you are here. When you are here, it is equal. So it's mutual. But when you are starting, you need them. People were like, you know, lot of women, lot of college girls, you know, who were just finished their college, you know, getting into their corporate life, searching for jobs and all that stuff. So they said that, you know, Subhana, can you help us? Can you guide us? You know, what we are doing, what should we do? Even we want to be home chefs, or just tell us that, you know, how can. So there were women who were like, you know, tired of traveling Churchgate to Virar, and they were like, we had enough of this and please tell us how we can start our own business. So I was guiding them. Over a period of time, then I realized that, you know, when my ammi said that you are actually guiding so many people, why don't you make a proper program? You know, rather than just doing it in a very haphazard or a way, just make it into a proper structure, and so that, you know, you will have people from different walks of life at different stages. So there are some who are like startups, there are some who are somewhere in the middle, and there are some who are already in an established business and want to beef up their business and all that stuff. So that's when we started the Women Entrepreneur Program. So now, you know, my niece and my nephew also have got involved. So we have enough hands, you know, to take care of everything.
Correct. I'm just happy that there are people that you are delegating stuff to, and that you're not, you know, having to take the whole burden of everything yourself, right? I mean,
you know, the logistics and the social media part, that's handled by me. The delivery part is taken care of by my niece and my nephew, and the cooking part, the cooking and the stocks and everything, that's managed by my sister, which is overlooked by our head in charge, which is my mother.
Yeah.
So she's here and she will take care of the entire thing. Okay, this is happening, that is happening. So that's how it goes. Yes.
So thank you so much for being a part of the Ashish David Show, Shabana.
Thank you.
I know you're a very, very busy woman. You've got a lot of things to do. And, you know, the most important relationship in your life, which is the one with food, you know, you have to take time out from that and do this show. So I'm very, very grateful. You're such a positive person. You know, you're full of energy and enthusiasm. And after talking to you for almost an hour, I can tell that, you know, why are you so happy and full of energy is because you're doing everything that you love. And I'm pretty sure that most of my listeners who are watching you right now will be super inspired by you, and they would most definitely want to know more about you, and they're going to check you out. And if they're in the Mumbai area, they're going to check out your food as well, most importantly. Ammi's Kitchen is the place that you need to order food from. Well, it might not be stuff that you have tasted, but then that's the reason why you probably want to go and taste it, because it's different and new. And now that you know the person behind the food and the story, I'm pretty sure, you know, all the audiences will be super excited about this.
Awesome! I was just waiting that, you know, okay, what all questions are you going to ask? So I think I've answered everything. And I've spoken everything.
Dekho, the very same way that, you know, people who order food from your place don't only order once, na? वैसे ये जो हमारा interview है, एक बार नहीं हो रहा, ये आगे भी होगा. तो अगर कुछ अभी बच गया ना, जैसे मेरे साथ जैसे होता है, जैसे मैं बुफे में जाता हूँ तो बच जाता ना, मैं बोलता हूँ बेटा अगली बार आऊंगा, तुझे छोड़ूंगा नहीं मैं. So
Correct.
There's going to be a next time, and hopefully when we meet next time, we're going to have an amazing conversation and hum khoob sari aur baatein bhi karenge when we meet next time.
Thank you so much for inviting me, and I really had a great time. I think I have shared everything from my initial days of corporate life to Ammi's Kitchen, and thank you so much.
Absolutely, and it was lovely talking to you, and we shall meet very soon again.
Yes.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you.